All he said was, I feel dizzy, and boom, that was it.
Eileen Barcombe's husband, Lyle, fell unconscious behind the wheel of their moving car.
So I climb over him, over the console, trying to get his foot off the gas, trying to get my foot on the brake, steering the car, trying to get in the right-hand lane and looking for traffic coming.
Eileen pulled the car over and ran around to check on Lyle.
He's slumped over. I put the seat back a little bit, and I pounded on his chest twice. And he gasped, and I said, don't you dare leave me. I said, I'm not ready for you to be gone.
Minutes later, some Boy Scouts and their troop leader stopped to help.
She grabs him by the belt, puts him on the ground.
Troop leader Mary Jane Adelot is also paramedic firefighter MJ with the Pattonville Fire Protection District. While MJ started CPR, the troop helped secure the scene.
Us scouts, we were starting to like kind of direct traffic before all the like emergency people got there.
So that was just all part of their training that they've gone through that kicked in.
MJ says her scouts are all trained in CPR and they were able to see firsthand the life-saving benefits of that skill.
Knowing that what we've learned here at Scouts, we can like it actually has a purpose, and this shows you can use it in your daily life and in helping people and doing what is the right thing.
The Monarch Fire Protection District arrived moments after. They say time is of the essence in cases like this, and MJ being there even a minute before they were may have made all the difference.
Having that pre-CPR prior to our arrival, that's absolutely essential, absolutely essential.
Lyle was rushed to St. Luke's Hospital, where he is improving each day.
For him to make this full recovery is a miracle, and I'm glad I was in the right place at the right time.
Like I said, thank you's not enough. They saved my husband's life.